So now, if in evolution, the chimpanzee became a human person, how is that possible? St. Thomas says, you cannot give what you don't have. Of course. Of course. But if the spirit abides, it's the spirit that makes something new emerge. How could the church change if there's no spirit that inspires and assists and guides? We would have been a white church of long ago, as the Jewish faith is, as the Hindu faith is. Our church is very much alive because something new emerges all the time. There is an evolution of morality. Do you know that St. Paul did not abrogate, did not say anything against slavery? He in fact asked Onesimus, no, to give back to Philemon, because he doesn't own him. Though he baptized him, he said, sorry, my son, you can't stay with me in Rome. That is injustice. Your amo, your master, and you are the slave, you've got to go back there. Now as a Christian, not just with some other law, but I will write a letter for you to Philemon. And he said, Philemon, Onesimus, I cannot deserve it because you didn't give him to me. I return to you, I told him, go back to you. But I tell you, since I baptize you and I baptize Onesimus, both of you are my father, I am your father. Therefore, your brothers, please treat him not just as a slave, but as a brother. But you own him. But that's still a slave. Now, when you think about the church sustaining slavery, of course not. We know better than God. We know better about Jesus than John's gospel. Why? Because the Spirit I will give you as a parable, he will tell you the truth. The insight of what I have said, the implications in life. But when will it come? When humanity is ready. When there is a readiness of humanity to accept largely the presence of the Spirit. Spirit will be more diffusive. But how does he start? How does the Spirit start? He raises a prophet. He raises a founder, a foundress, a Benedict of Nursia. He raises a Francis of Assisi, a Dominic de Guzman, an Ignatius of Loyola, a Julian Amar. He raises prophets among God's people. He raises a Mother Teresa, an Ursuline sister of Loreto, who at the 1930s, I think, early 40s, submitted her letter asking for dispensation from vows to return as a lay woman in Calcutta because she would want to take care of the poorest of the poor. Madre na to, asked the Holy Father in the early 40s, late 30s, to be dispensed, impossible, but was given. Because this came from an inspiration of the Spirit, a gift of the Spirit. And when she started working, the alumni of that institution started to gravitate to her. And before she knew it, that's why she was asked for to leave, to found again a group of sisters. And this time, very much connected with the need of the church, the poorest of the poor. You know when she died? The National Congress of India, the parliament, took from the museum the carriage that carried the dead body of Mohandas Gandhi and even later Nehru, the fathers of democracy of India, the fathers of India as a nation, out of the museum, carrying the body of Mother Teresa. When some fundamentalist Hindus asked the parliament, why did you say that degree? Why did you put that degree? She's not even Indian. She's from Albania. She's not even Hindu. She's a Catholic. And the answer is, because she's the mother of India. Oh. Now we realize, even the Spirit is at work in other religions, guiding them to the understanding of harmony, unity. Mother Teresa, foreigner, Catholic, honored at the same level as Gandhi and Nehru in India. Why? Kindred spirits. The spirit at work in the hearts of the good, the just, the noble, the people who are truthful. You know, if the spirit works in you, you will never anymore say, kasi tayo si Sergio, wala akong pakailan dyan. Why? Ay, ibang kongregasyon yan. Ba't ako makipag-usap dyan? Why? There's so much to learn from each other. There's so much to give as an enrichment to each other. We're all the ones segmenting. We're the ones dividing. We're the ones putting walls. The Spirit connects, offers so many a variety of gifts. While there are a variety of gifts, there's one Spirit. While there are a variety of works, there is one Lord. There might be a variety of gifts of activities, but there's only one now. So this is what Paul says and gives us the body. Can it only be all eyes or ears or feet or nose? How could the feet say, I don't need the eyes? How could it walk without the eyes? How could the eyes say that I don't need the feet? How could it walk if it's only able to see? The body of Christ, and the soul, the one that amalgamates, the one that proceeds from the Father and the Son, makes the creative, redemptive work into the fullness of holiness, sanctification, is the abiding presence of the Spirit. Can I shock you? Even the Spirit is present in the devil. How could he exist without the Holy Spirit? That is where you find God self-emptying. He loves the devil. How could it exist if God doesn't choose the devil to exist? In his selfless love, he even allows his enemy to exist. Why? When you committed mortal sin, did you die? God still loved you. But what is good for us is that we have time. You know why we have time? Because we have body. The Spirit has no body. The angel has no body. I take my body, I take time to go from one space to the other. Space needs time. Takes me to God. Since I have space, I need time. So time offers me time to change. The angels, no. Once you decide, that's your fundamental option. That's it. And yet God says, you chose against me. How did they choose against God? I don't know, but my hunch as a theologian is, he was presented the Son of God, incarnate, humble as a man. Will you serve as a man? And the angel said, no, I will not lower myself to serve. That is his decision. So you know, he's very intelligent. He knows he cannot destroy man, but destroy God. He wants to destroy God. That's when he puts out the LGBT, he puts out the contraceptives. You know, we're kidding ourselves. We're just kidding ourselves. The contraceptive and passion. We're kidding our human race. Marseille, French, is 50% Muslim. So is Holland, so is coming to be Germany, even Spain and probably Italy in the border. And now, who are the ones? Over a million migrating from Syria. Muslims. And they are now filling up immediately 1 million of people for Europe. And why? Well, we accept them that they will die. We would not have children. We just have dogs. It's easier to have dogs than children. They don't need to go to college. We will not fear anywhere. They will take drugs. I'm more comfortable with my dog than with children. something good. So therefore, the Spirit gives us the courage to face sacrifices. The Spirit urges us to be ourselves, self-giving, to the point of selflessness. So if you want your evangelization to succeed, you've got to be Spirit-filled. Because what will sustain you in your work is the presence of the Spirit. Invoke the Spirit. Invoke them on the children. Invoke them on the parents. By the way, as I think Monsignor Jerry has heard, the Philippine problem is not lack of catechists. The problem in the Philippines is lack of adult catechesis. Because the children will never be able to teach their parents. But the parents can teach their children. So please, make the parents catechists. And how? I told you, make the Sunday Mass engaging. Allow them to be able to repeat what they heard in Sunday to their family first, and then to the family members that are not in church, like maids, kasambahay, drivers, nandun sa beauty parlor, I don't know, suki mo sa talipapa. It's the lay people who know the sick that do not go to church. They are in their offices. They are among themselves in their kasambahay, in their kapitbahayan. We cannot do it. It's a church work. Now, how do we engage them to that? Sustaining that belief of the Holy Spirit's presence in their hearts and giving them courage and strength. Not to be preaching as much as to reach out and believe that, you know, this is the work of grace in our life. I really feel that this 2021 is a signature year. 500 years of Christianity, with a proof of life, the Santo Niño de Cebu. No country Catholic can boast it has a statue from the existence of Christianity in the country. We got it in our country. That's when we became Catholic. In the first 800 baptisms of Cebu, with King Humabon and Queen Hara Amihan, not Aramihan, Hara Amihan, given the statues. You know what, brothers and sisters? According to Father Rico Ayo, reading the Pigafetta Chronicles, which is online, found digital, but in old Italian, probably the first catechist in the Philippines is Magella. He introduced Humabon, that who are they? They are children of the Creator God, of the God Creator King. While they belong to the kingdom of Isabella, the Queen, they belong to the children of God. And so they proposed to Humabon, do you want to be the children, the son of the Most High God? Simple catechism. I suppose, of course, any politician would like to be the son of the king. And you accept it. And why did Magellan get killed? And because nagalit sila Bulaco. And so Magellan says, I'll defend you, ayon, nakagulo. So I think the story of Magellan needs to be looked into. Father Carlo Mountain said, no. Sabi mo sa ABS-CBN, kung wala sila ng Magellan killed. No, and good person thing, I pick side, and it makes sense. Huh? It's 500 years. The first circumnavigator of the world with his fleet. It's very historical, geographical, world-changing, fantastic idea. And for the Philippines, it's Magellan. You get the whole Mahati in business district, because they got the name of Urdaneta, the priest, Legazpi, the captain, diba? And Salcedo, brother the captain, they asked me the other, and Magallanes. You get all of these people who are married and tell them to fund the bill. Because their names of their villages will be in the bill. What I'm saying is that, I don't know, the Spirit comes like that to suggest, to come out like this. As Father Jenny was saying, this proposal of 9 years of 2021, it did not come from me, it came from a layman, from the media. In his desire of evangelization, dedicating his movement to the evangelization, massive, rapid, he thought of a 9-year preparation, after a 10-year preparation. So, where does the Spirit come from? From everyone, because he's in you. Now, the sad part about the devil is that they don't heed the Spirit's inspiration. In fact, they assert against the Spirit. But the Spirit, in its own humility, allows life to continue. Nakabili ba Diyos, ano? Kaaway mo na. Pinapayagan mo ka mamuhay. Salamat sa Diyos. Buhay pa sa tayo. Eh, paano din naging kaaway na ng Diyos? Ano rin pa? Pero may muli ko ng Diyos. Sabi niya, if you're faithful, I will be faithful. If you're not faithful, I will remain faithful. Why? Because I cannot deny myself. I cannot be like you. I am God. And as being God, I am always faithful. Thanks be to God. And the faithful God to us that abided from the first big bang to the present day and towards the absolute future is the Spirit. In us. In our midst. The book says it's exploration. In reference to creation, what is the role of the Spirit? Romans chapter 8, Kumbantorona. The Spirit suffers with the woman giving birth. Creation is in groaning. Humanity is groaning. And the Spirit groans with all humanity in creation. So the Spirit, and for that matter, the Trinity, joined humanity in its suffering, in its desire to be better. It's not away from God, suffering. And his suffering is not by solving it with a flick of a finger. His suffering is by joining man in the suffering. It's incarnational. Because of that incarnational method of God, if we want humanity to be better, we are willing to lay down our lives for our friends, for our children. Okay? I leave you a paper, the Holy Spirit, in the person and the mission according to Evangelii Gaudium. I discuss here a bit about the Trinitarian dimension, and of course, the proclamation of the joy of the gospel is because of the Spirit. Because Jesus overjoyed that the gospel was given to those who are not converted. And finally, Pope Francis says we need to have Spirit-filled evangelizers. Three parts of this text. I produce it in 3 pages in smaller letters. And if you want to multiply it, there you have got a bit of a summary in text form. Okay. Any question? Gutom na kayo. Tapos na po ako.